I recently got one, and I got some free games with it. One of the free games was The Division, so I thought I might as well play some. I've actually been really enjoying it, which I was surprised by, to be honest. I know the game got some not so good reviews when it came out. It seems to have improved quite a lot anyway. I've been having fun with it, and the environments, as you can see, are interesting and quite varied. I like the adverts and stuff. I think it was meant to be getting close to Christmas at the time when the there's like a virus that's broke out. But yeah, you can see lots of Christmas stuff around on the adverts. And there's obviously food that's been stockpiled in a supermarket. A lot of it's been taken, obviously. Was quite funny. PS4, not a PC. It's very impressive. Oh, some baddies. Quite a lot of baddies. I think I'm gonna have to use my, I think I probably used my turret in this. Because you have a few special abilities. One of them is that radar scanning thing that I keep using. And the other one is that turret. I usually throw it out and then start shooting them at the same time. Because it starts shooting them as well. It's a very useful ability. Most of the people I've played with online have been using that turret. And most have also been using the scanner as well. There's a few that obviously use some of the more support type abilities as well. But yeah, you kill people and they drop guns and stuff. It's pretty, it's a fun. And stuff that are open. Obviously, I remember the one of the first trailers. close a car door. That got a lot of attention. I actually got surprised here with the footprints in the snow. I thought that was a pretty cool detail. There's a dog. A little pup. Seems to be enjoying rooting through the rubbish bags. And there's a pigeon. Yeah, there's also lots of posters on the wall and stuff. Concerts, porky pies, fancy a scoop, protest. Just lots of stuff. Just adds a bit more. Story. And then you got these massive military vehicles that appear to have squashed a very unfortunate person. Another doggy here. He seems a bit suspicious. I'll leave him alone. Yeah, I was curious what was in these buckets on top of this vehicle. I can't climb around outside. They let me climb up here. And then they're all closed up anyway. See anything. I guess it might be, I don't know, infected materials. That looks like a big load of infected materials. It's a newsstand thing. Free news. And stop over this. You can see some sheds over there. They were obviously gathering infected people and, I don't know, trying to treat them, I guess. Or quarantine them at least. See, the workers passed away there as well. And some body bags, well, body sheets. And an open manhole cover. I think this bit is actually for a later mission. They have these quite big missions that are part of the main story. I think that must be to do with one of them, maybe. Or it's just a safe house type thing that I haven't opened yet. I tried whacking it open, but that didn't work. Yeah. Oh, another baddie. This guy's a level 13, though. It's a bit more dangerous, but he's on his own, so I can just throw my turret and sort of let it work on him. There you go. Easy. Yeah, the next mission I've got to do, I think, is a level 18 mission. So, that's going to be fun. You usually have to have at least semi-decent people. Otherwise, you haven't really got a chance at all. You just keep dying and keep dying and keep dying. And even with good people, you'll fail a lot of times before you finally get a little bit further forward to the next checkpoint, and then you'll still fail again. So you have to just try a bit more, get a little bit more further. There's some more of the story. I'm going to play that though. I think it's an audio file. You can listen to some of the audio files. They're pretty interesting. There was one audio file that was like a call from one guy who was asking his friend if to play a certain game that night. That was pretty cool. Maybe like a bunch of school buses around here. Being from the UK, they look really weird. And the ambulances, none of it's anything really like what we have for ambulances and school buses. It's just quite interesting. And then obviously the massive tall buildings. We don't really have them around here either. There's some more military vehicles. And no entry sign. I'm gonna go down there anyway. It's a very, very lonely world. It does feel like it's got a lot of stuff in it still, even though it feels very lonely. Oh, and there's also these shops. They sometimes have resources that you can, I think you can craft with them. weapons and armor and stuff. Although I haven't actually tried that out yet, to be honest. Usually they're in these boxes, but they're all empty in this shop for some reason. And then usually in the back there's a bigger case. Instead of just crafting materials, usually get a gun or some armor. I'm using my scan in there just to check where some people are. They're around that corner, so I'm not really gonna go there. It's best not to get in a fight unless you like really have to. Otherwise you're just gonna wasting all your ammo. There's also some movie posters. I always check the movie posters. I was checking them all the way through The Last of Us as well. I think they sort of reference the next game in a way. Someone was saying that anyway. Lots and lots of car doors open, ready to push close. A massive building. Huge buildings all around. Look at them. Massive. I mean, I've been to London and stuff, so I've seen pretty tall buildings, but even in London, they're not all that tall. There's usually areas where it's quite tall, and most of the other places it's sort of medium. Oh, and this is the dark zone, I believe. It's like a sort of PvP area. I haven't actually gone in it yet, because I'm kind of scared. It says you can lose stuff, so I don't really want to try it yet. I'm just showing how the map is all the red bit. I'm just on the edge. You can see all the collectibles here. Crash drone. Incident report. Missing agents. You can also see the outlines of the buildings. I remember there was some controversies about the map as well. When this game came out, people were saying it didn't look like the trailer. But there you go. Oh, this was pretty cool. I believe this is in Broadway. I don't know. But there's loads of pretty lights and adverts, and it's just really vibrant.